From delayed eyesight to a stomach of steel. Stay tuned to number one to find out which part of the human body can actually grow back. Number 10, delayed eyesight. You would think that our eyes register what they see right away, this very instant. But this is only partially true. Here's what actually happens. Our eyes do register the outside world right away, but it takes some time for the brain to get the signal from the eyes. So it does all happen that very second, but not necessarily that very millisecond. It turns out that humans pick up the visual signals immediately, but our brain cannot decipher them for at least 12 to 13 milliseconds. At MIT, a research was conducted and the subjects were shown a series of images, with every single image lasting from 13 to 18 milliseconds. Then, as the experiment went along, the exposure time for every image got shorter and shorter. 13 milliseconds was the lowest threshold for image recognition. Since the brain doesn't register the visual input right away, we can say that, technically speaking, we're all living in the past. Pretty far out. Number 9. Invisible stripes. Well, it turns out our bodies are covered in stripes, but they happen to be invisible. Ever heard of Blaschko lines? At the start of the 20th century, there was a German doctor named Alfred Blaschko, whose field of expertise was dermatology, or the study of the skin. After some research, Dr. Blaschko found out that the moles and rashes on human skin actually weren't randomly dispersed, but instead had a very particular order. He started noticing patterns that moles and rashes followed, and those patterns were separate from the patterns of nerves or blood vessels. Blaschko thought that he got them all, but as technology advanced, it was later discovered that there were even more than his original number. These patterns, named after the doctor who discovered them, are a direct result of our cells' migration as they move around to make room for new cells as our body grows. The amazing thing is that the shapes of the patterns are different for each section of our body. So, there's a V shape on our back, an S shape on our sides and our chest, whereas our head is covered in wavy shapes. Who would have thought, huh? Number 8. The plot thickens. Our body was designed as the perfect mechanism. It protects itself and prepares for bad situations on the horizon. As an example, when stress and anxiety hit our body, it responds by activating blood coagulation. The reason for this is to prepare for potential damage to the system, because if a physical injury happens, there is a high chance of hemorrhage. The blood can begin to thicken in advance so that clotting can be encouraged and prepared in case of incident. However, this can often lead to more trouble. Although quick blood coagulation is a good measure in the short term, it might result in fatal consequences. Studies have shown that patients with anxiety disorders stand a 3 to 4 times higher chance of dying from heart failure, because stress-caused coagulation can easily lead to a heart attack. So don't get too angry or too nervous. It really isn't good for you. Number 7. The brain ignores the nose. This may sound like an English idiom, but it's not. It's actually one of those facts of life. Yep, our brain simply ignores our nose. Not as a body part, but as a visual object. There is a neurological process called sensory gating, which is nothing more than a fancy term for the filtering of information. The human brain is constantly being bombarded with all kinds of information in the form of visual, audio, and other sensory stimuli, and it has to sort out what the heck is going on with all of that data. This is why the brain came up with a brilliant idea, to filter out the given information and make a priority list. Basically, our brain is such a skilled computer that it can literally notice every single stimuli in the blink of an eye, every breath, every tongue movement, and every motion that the body takes. It just chooses not to because it doesn't have to. There's no practical need for it. Have you ever tried looking at your nose? Okay, so you actually can do it, but there's no need for it because there's plenty more important stuff to pay attention to. So the nose gets literally overlooked. Now you're looking for your nose. Tell us if you find it in the comments below. And while you're there, don't forget to hit that subscribe button so you can stay up to date with all of our newest videos. Number 6. Completing the blind spot. The blind spot is an interesting phenomenon of our visual senses. Literally speaking, it is any obscuration of the human visual field. It occurs because there's no photoreceptor cells to detect light on optic discs. Thus, that part of the visual field is literally invisible to us. The blind spot, or the blind point as it is referred to, was discovered by a Frenchman named Edmond Mariette in the 1600s. So, how come we don't notice these blind spots? Well, we should thank our brain for it. Again, the brain proves to be a heck of a computing device. Although one part of the visual field is missing, it's not all of it, so the brain does the next logical thing. It assumes. Yep, the brain processes the given data and logically draws the conclusion for you. For example, if you're at the beach and there's sand all around you, the brain will fill in the gap and tell itself that there's also sand in the missing part of the visual field. Pretty crazy, right? Number 5. So many muscles. We're still in the believe it or not section of our list, so check this one out. No one can tell you how many muscles you've got. Seriously, it does sound unbelievable, but it's true. The problem with counting all the muscles in the human body stems from the problem of muscle categorization. There's no consensus on what should or shouldn't be considered a muscle. Basically, all of our muscles are separated into three categories: skeletal, cardiac, and smooth. Skeletal muscles are those that move voluntarily, like a leg or an arm. The cardiac muscle is a single involuntary muscle in the walls of the heart. But the troublemakers are the smooth muscles, found in the skin, blood vessels, urinary tract, and more, because no one can tell precisely how many of them there are. So, regarding the muscles, our body is still unexplored territory. We're some mystery, folks. Number 4. So many tears. Just like the muscles, we have three distinct types of tears. Think about it for a moment. It's not the same when you're crying while cutting onions versus when you're heartbroken, right? Well, the reason is that it's from different types of tears. The first category is the so-called basal tears. They occur all the time and are actually necessary for our survival. Who would have thought we needed tears to survive? But these tears are produced to keep our eyes lubricated and wet 24/7. Then there are reflex tears, those dreaded onion tears, but also those happening as a result of severe eye irritation, foreign particles, chemicals, and the like. And then the famous psychic tears, from laughing too hard, crying over a breakup, or hitting your shin bone against something hard. And the reason why these three types of tears are different is their evolutionary purpose. Basal tears are there to keep us alive and well and are full of antibacterial elements, salts, and oils, while the other two types contain hormones that are relevant to the set of emotions we're expecting, such as anger, pain, sadness, joy, and sorrow. Number 3. The stomach of destruction. This might sound like a B-horror movie from the 1950s, but it's actually quite a fitting description of our internal organ. Our stomach is a real powerhouse. It is in charge of a very important task: to digest the food we eat and to get rid of all the harmful things that reach it, such as bacteria and the like. In order to do so, the stomach has to have solid weapons. And it does. Meet gastric acid. Gastric acid is a combination of hydrochloric acid, potassium chloride, and sodium chloride. And it's one potent combination, that's for sure. When something enters it, it activates the digestive enzymes and kills all the bacteria in its radius. The absolutely amazing thing is that gastric acid is very, very strong. With a pH level from 1.5 to 3.5, it rakes extremely high on the acidity scale. However, it doesn't harm the insides of the stomach lining. Crazy enough, numerous experiments have been conducted proving that gastric acid even dissolves some objects made of stainless steel. Number 2. The brain feels no pain. When your leg hurts, or when you're hit somewhere on your body, the nerve impulses travel fast and reach the brain where they report about the pain. Without these pain receptors, as they're called, there would be no pain. You simply wouldn't be able to feel any. But what's interesting is that the brain itself actually cannot feel any pain. The brain simply registers the input, interpreting it as pain and placing it in the proper category. The reason why the brain cannot feel anything is simple. It has no pain receptors. And the pain in your head, for example, doesn't come from the brain itself. It probably comes from the membranes around the brain. So being that our brain is pain-free, if you could touch it, you wouldn't feel anything. And I wouldn't recommend trying this at home. Number 1. The liver refuses to go. Our liver is simply a magical organ. It's in charge of a very important task to cleanse us from all the bad stuff in our blood. It filters the blood that enters it from the digestive tract before letting it out to other parts of our body. The liver metabolizes all of the medicine we take, and it also detoxifies us. Pretty amazing, right? But what's even more amazing is the liver's ability to regenerate itself. For instance, if something unpleasant happens to it, such as chemical damage or a surgery that would cause a chunk of it to get removed, it will simply grow back, if all of the necessary conditions are there. Only 25% of the liver's mass is enough for it to start regenerating, and soon it will grow back to its original size. Now, the liver doesn't necessarily go back to its original form, but it does restore all of its original mass and function, which is absolutely incredible since it's our only organ to do so. Tell us what you think about these incredible facts about the human body in the comments below, and take care.